Hi guys, I'm Shruti and welcome to Karmakar's Kitchen. Happy Thanksgiving! No, I'm not going to share any turkey recipe or corn or pumpkin pie recipe which people usually make on Thanksgiving. But today I'm going to share a recipe which is very close to my heart. I'm talking about fish and chips. We had the opportunity to taste fish and chips back in London. When we were traveling to Brighton, there for the first time we tasted fish and chips and I totally fell in love with it.
Here are some pictures of Brighton. You can see fish and chips joint right over there. We have some beautiful memories of London and Brighton. Fish and chips being the staple food of UK, we had it on many occasions. These pictures are dated back to 2007.
So today's recipe, which I'm going to share, is very authentic and traditional way of making fish and chips. So I'm going to share fish, chips, and mushy peas. Traditionally, it is served with mushy peas. So here is the recipe. Enjoy.
To make beer batter fish and chips, we need boneless fish. So here I have taken cod fillet, about 230 grams, thoroughly washed. Alternatively, you can use haddock, pollock, basa, vetki, or any other fillet of your choice. For the chips, we are gonna need potatoes. Here I have got two large potatoes, peeled and washed, cut in long stripes. And we are not making McDonald's or KFC fries, people. We are making British chips. So the first step is to blanch the potatoes, for which heat enough oil for deep frying the potatoes. Once it's at the right temperature, drop the potatoes gradually. Oil should not be very hot. Fry on medium to low flame for 5 to 7 minutes. Blanching means cooking for a short time without color. So we don't want the chips to get on any color. We will be double deep frying the chips later. Chips have parcooked without color, so transfer them on a paper towel and rest for a while. We will get back to it later. Meanwhile, let's prepare the beer batter for the fish. So here I have got all-purpose flour, which is maida, about 150 grams, into which I am adding rice flour, about 50 grams. Rice flour is optional, but I would recommend because it adds extra crunch to the fish. Into this goes baking powder, 1 teaspoon. Salt, 1 teaspoon. Freshly ground black pepper, about 1 teaspoon. Cold beer. Use any brand of your choice. Now, traditionally, beer is used for this batter, but if you don't want to add, then simply use plain soda water or sparkling water. Add beer in small amount at a time. We need batter little bit thicker, not too runny. Fish and chips have remained cultural icon in the United Kingdom for centuries. You'll find it in pubs, restaurants, or any shops on the street. Check for the consistency. It should be neither too thick nor too runny. Now let it sit for 15 to 20 minutes while we work on the mushy peas. For the mushy peas, here I'm heating a pan and I have added cooking oil, about 2 teaspoons. Use any refined oil, better if you can source olive oil. Bake it nice and hot. Add chopped shallots or onions, about 3 teaspoons. Minced garlic, about 1 tablespoon. Saute on a medium to high flame for about 2 to 3 minutes. Add blanched peas, about 100 grams. These are parboiled. If you are using fresh peas, then please boil them first before adding into the pan. Add salt, about 1/2 teaspoon. Freshly ground black pepper, about 1/2 teaspoon again. Stir and mix everything very nicely. Cook on medium flame. Now I'm gonna add butter, about 1 tablespoon. Let the butter melt nicely and mix it well with the peas. Peas have cooked nicely. Now mash these with the help of a spatula. or a masher. You can blend the whole thing with a hand blender. We are not done yet. Time to add some chopped mint leaves, which is pudina leaves. It adds a nice flavor to the mushy peas. Many people don't know about mushy peas. Traditionally, it is served as a side dish along with fish and chips. It's done and ready. Now let's get back to the chips. Chips have rested for a while. Now we are gonna deep fry them for the second time. Fry on medium to high flame, because this time we want the chips to get on some color. So we are gonna fry until it's crisp and golden brown. Chips have turned beautiful golden brown. Now take them out on a paper towel. It looks so tempting, guys. Now pat dry the excess oil and transfer it in a bowl. Now it's time for seasoning, so sprinkle some salt, paprika powder, freshly ground black pepper, sprinkle some dried parsley leaves. Now mix everything very nicely so that the chips are coated well with spices. Do this process when the chips are still piping hot. Done with the chips, keep it aside in a warm place. Now let's go back to the fish. Here I have got some flour, about 1 cup for dredging the fish, and I am adding about 1/2 teaspoon of salt into it and black pepper powder. Mix it nicely. Now get the first fillet and dredge it really well in the flour. Make sure it's covered really well with the flour. It's gonna be messy, but don't worry about it. Pat and shred excess flour into the batter, coat it really well and leave it there. Same goes with the second fillet. Repeat the process and finish off coating all the fillets. It's time to fry the fillet. Oil should be really hot for frying the fish. Gently drop the fillet, laying away from you. It quickly puffs up. Beautiful. Here goes the another one. Splash oil on top of it and in about 2 minutes, flip over the fillets. Fry on medium flame. Take time and fry until it's golden brown. Fish have turned beautiful golden brown. Now take them out on a paper towel. With the remaining batter, you can make onion rings, potato wedges or fried shrimps. Fry the remaining pieces. If you wish, you can reverse the process by frying the fillet first and then the chips. This way you will get piping hot chips to serve with fish. Done with the frying, fish is absolutely crisp and so tempting. And now it's time for plating. So serve with a slice of lemon, mushy peas, chips and tartar sauce. And there you have the best authentic British fish and chips. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please leave a like and a comment. Also subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my videos. I'll see you next week. Till then, take a good care of yourself and stay safe. Bye-bye.